Hello everyone, this is Chris from Spoon Graphics, back with another video tutorial for Adobe Illustrator. Now, a big new movie trailer was released recently for Thor Ragnarok, which features a cool 80s inspired chrome text effect in the title art. I've already produced a tutorial on how to create such an effect in Adobe Photoshop, so I thought I'd use this example to show how similar effects can be created in Illustrator. We'll use Illustrator's simple 3D tool to give the text that three-dimensional appearance, then create the shiny chrome look with a series of gradient fills. So begin by creating a new document in Adobe Illustrator. I'm going for a generic A4 layout, but with the units set to pixels and the color mode as RGB. We'll be using some raster effects, so make sure these are set to high. Select the rectangle tool and clear out the default white fill by clicking the none icon. Switch the black stroke over to use it as the fill color. Draw a rectangle to cover the entire artboard from top left to bottom right, aligning it carefully to each corner. The default black fill in Illustrator is actually the CMYK black, so since we're using the RGB color mode, we can actually make this black even blacker by moving the color sliders to zero. Go to Object Lock and Selection to avoid accidentally moving this shape out of place. There's a couple of free display fonts that are a good match to what's used in the official Thor Ragnarok logo. They're named Dameron and Modi Thorsen. Dameron in particular is pretty much spot on, but Modi Thorsen is the closest I could find for the word Ragnarok. Links to both are down in the description area. Set out the two words of Thor and Ragnarok in their respective fonts, then adjust the sizing and kerning as necessary. Use the align buttons in the top toolbar to center them up. With both text elements selected, go to Effect 3D in Extrude and Bevel. Change the settings to 1400 for the orientation with a perspective of 45 degrees. Click the More Options button and then change the blend steps to 0. Check the preview icon to see the effect in action. If you notice some of the faces are missing, a quick fix for this glitch is to increase the rotation to 1 degree, then back to 0. Go to the Object menu and select Expand Appearance to permanently apply this 3D effect, then right-click and select Ungroup. Right-click and select Ungroup again to completely break apart all the pieces. Apply a gradient fill to all the shapes, then double-click the first gradient swatch in the gradient panel. By default, Illustrator only uses the K channel, so quickly add a random swatch to bring up the RGB values, then configure the color to 11500. Change the other colour in the gradient flow to 3500, which transitions from a light to a dark red. In some areas of the 3D effect, particularly any curved surfaces, the outline is split into a number of pieces. Hold the Shift key and select these shapes and click the Unite button from the Pathfinder panel to neaten up each letter. Currently, all the gradients are flowing in the same direction. It's a tedious process for just a subtle change, but randomly changing the gradient flow for each shape improves the overall appearance. Use the gradient tool to click and drag a different direction for each shape. You can quickly toggle back to the selection tool to click the next shape by holding the command key. Hold the shift key and select the four letter faces that make up the word Thor. Right click and select group, then change the first gradient swatch color to yellow, which is 255-2550 in RGB values. Change the second gradient color to a darker orange of 255-140-0. Hold the Alt key, then click and drag the gradient swatches to make an alternating series of colors between yellow and orange, then tidy them up by evenly spacing them out. Change the gradient angle to 90 degrees so the bands flow horizontally across the type. With the text faces still selected, go to Object Path and Offset Path, enter -3 pixels in the options. In the gradient panel, drag away all the additional swatches in the gradient setup to remove them, leaving just a basic yellow to orange gradient. Make sure the flow begins with orange at the bottom, so change the angle to -90 degrees. Activate the stroke setting in the toolbar, then apply the yellow swatch that's available below it. Change the settings to align to inside from within the stroke panel. Shift and select all the letter faces that make up the word Ragnarok, then group them together. Go to Edit and Copy, followed by Edit and Paste in front. Change the first gradient swatch of this word's fill to 214255255. Add an extra swatch in the middle and use a light blue of 100, 230, 255. Then alter the darkest color to 0, 50, 150. Alter the angle to 90 degrees so the gradient flows from the darker blue at the top. Select the line tool and clear out the gradient fill, replacing it with just a black stroke. Draw a straight line from one side of the word to the other while holding the shift key. Increase the stroke weight to 3 points, and hold the alt key and nudge upwards with the cursor key to make a duplicate. Position the second line around halfway up the text, then reduce the stroke weight to 1 point. Add the first line to the selection, then go to Object, Blend and Make. Head straight back to Object, Blend and Blend options, and change the settings to Specified Steps and the number to around 5. Move the blended line so there's an even gap at the bottom of the text, then go to Objects and Expand. This first expand command has converted the blend into stroked paths, but we need to expand again to convert the paths into outlined shapes. Click on the Ragnarok Text Faces group, then go to Object, Compound Path and Make. Add the blended lines to the selection, then click the minus front button in the Pathfinder panel to punch out the lines from the text. Grab the direct selection tool from the toolbar and select all the upper portions of each letter. Give them a white stroke and align it to the inside from within the stroke panel. We can make the little dividing line from the official logo by adding a small circle with the ellipse tool. Clear out the white stroke, then alter the gradient to flow from a single blue swatch to black, but change the opacity of the black swatch to 0. Change the gradient type from linear to radial. This circle can now be squashed and stretched out to form a long glow line. The main text effect is complete, but we can add a few more finishing touches to replicate the cosmic background where the logo appears in the trailer. Go to Object and Unlock All to activate the background rectangle, then select the Gradient Mesh tool. Click somewhere in the upper left region, and again somewhere in the lower right region to add some mesh points. Use the Direct Selection tool to select each mesh point in turn, and add a subtle blue colour. I'm using 20, 30, 40 for the first one, 20, 20, 30 for the second, 15, 20, 25 for the third, and 10, 15, 20 for the last one, all of which are really subtle variations of the same dark grey-blue colour. Select the ellipse tool and draw a small circle somewhere on the artboard. Change its fill to the previously used radial gradient, but change the first colour to white. Switch over to the transparency panel and change the blending mode to colour dodge to allow the gradient to interact with those subtle colours in the background. Create a new symbol out of this gradient circle, then delete the original. Select the symbol sprayer from the toolbar and click and drag a series of little stars all around the artboard. Click and hold the symbol sprayer tool group to select the symbol sizer, then hold the alt key while randomly clicking to reduce the size of some stars. Repeat the process with the symbol screener to fade some of them out, giving this space background a little more depth, as if some stars are further away than others. Right click and go to Arrange, Send to Back, followed by Bring Forward, to position the stars behind the text but on top of the gradient background. Alternatively, you could use the shortcuts Command Shift and the left square bracket key, and Command and the right square bracket key. The entire collection of stars can also be toned down by reducing the opacity to around 70%. In some empty space elsewhere in the document, draw a straight vertical line and give it a white stroke. Select the Rotate tool and click on the lowermost point, then hold the Alt key and drag out a copy, positioning it at a random angle. Repeat the process of plotting the rotate pivot point, then dragging out some more duplicate lines at random angles, then adjust the stroke weights between 1 and 6 points. Draw a selection around all these lines, then copy and paste in front a couple of duplicates, rotating each one to increase the number of flared lines. Select all the lines, then go to Effects, Blur and Gaussian Blur, enter 50 pixels, then position them centrally over the main artboard. Hold the Alt key to stretch out the flared lines so they extend beyond the artboard edges. Change the blending mode to Color Dodge and reduce the opacity to 10%. The final result replicates the shiny chrome effect of the Thor Ragnarok title logo pretty well, and shows how you can create some really cool retro wave style text effects in full vectors. So I hope these tips come in handy for your future projects. Be sure to stick around on my channel by hitting the subscribe button if you want to stick around for more. And don't forget to check out my older Photoshop-based tutorial for creating a similar 80s-style chrome text effect. Check out my website at spoon.graphics if you want to see what I get up to between these video tutorial uploads. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.